Okay, let's talk pneumo and hemothorax, okay? When we get into this, we're talking about air or blood within the pleural space. Okay, so we have our lung, and our lung is surrounded by what's called the pleura. And the pleura is a little sac that allows the lung to move in and out so that we can breathe comfortably. Now, what can happen with a pneumothorax is that air can get inside this space. It can actually shrink the lung as air escapes in here, and it's not able to get out. With hemothorax, this can fill with blood, and it can push the lung in because this pleura is an enclosed cavity, and that air, that blood, cannot get out. Okay, so that's what a hemothorax and a pneumothorax is. So there's a couple different kinds of pneumothorax. Again, pneumothorax means air. Okay, a spontaneous pneumothorax is that on this lung space here, we can get little blebs, B-L-E-B-S, and those little blebs can actually rupture and cause air to go out into the pleural space. That air, as it builds up pressure, will cause the lung to go down. Those blebs can be spontaneous. They can also be caused from emphysema or asthma. Okay, so those would be primary and secondary spontaneous pneumothorax. Tension pneumothorax, on the other hand, is when that pneumothorax, that air in that space, becomes so great that it actually causes the mediastinum to shift as it's pushing all this space over. This whole area shifts. Our trachea is going to deviate towards the unaffected side. It's going to actually cause a lot of pressure on the heart, which is going to affect venous return, and we're going to see a decrease in blood pressure. So that's what's going to happen when it becomes a tension pneumothorax. Shifted mediastinum, disruption of venous return to the heart, and this is an absolute medical emergency. Okay, hemothorax, on the other hand, as we said, is blood accumulation in the pleural space. Now, this can also happen from trauma. It can also happen iatrogenic, meaning in the hospital, from surgical procedures and things like that. So assessment, first thing we're going to see is dyspnea. We're going to hear decreased breath sounds on affected side. We're going to have unequal chest expansion, of course, because half of our lung fields are not going to be expanding as air is not entering or able to enter. We're going to see tracheal deviation on tension pneumothorax towards the unaffected side. Okay, so our trachea is going to deviate towards the good lung, because this area here is all pressed over, okay? We're gonna hear dullness on percussion on the affected side in hemothorax. We got all this blood in here, that's gonna sound really dull when we percuss. And we're gonna have hyporesonance on pneumothorax, okay? That affected side is gonna be filled with air. When we percuss, that's just gonna sound hollow. Some things we can do. If the pneumothorax is significant, we can put a chest tube in, and that can drain out the air. We'll put that to water seal. If the hemothorax, the way we get rid of a hemothorax is we actually do what is called a thoracentesis. The patient lies down on a table, okay, this would be their head. They lie down, the physician puts a large bore needle in, and we can suction out all of that blood. Okay, so that's the kind of the treatment for tension and pneumo and hemothorax. Again, chest tube would only be kind of needed in a very significant pneumothorax, the tension pneumothorax. Okay, guys, that is the pneumo and hemothorax. Thanks for listening, and be sure to subscribe to hear all the 2-minute RN videos.